What's up, everybody? I wanted to spend a few minutes today talking about baiting bears on public land in competitive environments. And 20 years ago when I first started baiting bears, it was super competitive here in Minnesota. And now I've hunted bears all over North America, and I've learned so much from a lot of different situations where I've done do-it-yourself baiting on public land in other states and also in Ontario. And I've been with so many outfitters and I've learned so much, but man, I really cut my teeth back in the day, public land, super competitive environment where there was a lot of people in the woods, and in Minnesota now, state forest land, timber company land, and county tax forfeit land is the type of things that I mostly baited. And back 20 years ago, there was a lot of bear tags issued. And in fact, you could draw a tag in most zones pretty much every year. So there were and a lot of baits in the woods. At that time, they didn't have a restriction on how many baits you could put out. So there were, you know, just about every bait that I had another bait within a mile or two of it. So I really learned a lot about how to get the bears on my bait and hold them, and the techniques that really work for that I've been able to carry on throughout these last 20 years. And I want to talk to you a little bit about some of the things that I learned and why you can really have an advantage over the other hunters if you actually really know what you're doing and do it right. So let's go through 7 points here. I'm going to give you 7 really important tips on how to be the one who has that bear on your bait, a mature male hopefully, that's coming in during the daylight, even in a competitive environment. And if you'll follow these 7 rules, it'll really help you. So number one is you've got to pick primo locations. You can't just sling a bait out there somewhere. You can't just put a pile of donuts in the woods and expect the bears to come. You've got to pick really, really top-notch locations. Now in Minnesota here, you can only have 3 baits per person. So I'm going to pick 3 really premier locations, and they might be 10 miles apart or more. And I might be traveling 30 minutes to get to one of them. You know, last year I traveled about 45 minutes to get to one of my baits, but it was so important because it's absolute premier locations. You want locations where those bears will feel comfortable coming in during the daylight. You got thick cover around, you got water right nearby. You want to create this environment where they feel comfortable and they have a sense of security, and then they'll stay there. You need the thick bedding cover, you need the water that they need every day. And you want to have your bait in that location where the bear is feeding there every day, and then he can go up and lay up nearby, and he doesn't have to travel very far so he won't come across other baits. Okay, that's tip number one. Number two is you got to get there first, and you got to get the bear on your bait first. So getting there first means that at the minute that it opens, that you can legally put out your baits, then you start baiting. And you know, here in Minnesota, it's about 2 weeks before the season opens that you can put out your baits. I'm going to be in the woods in these competitive environments putting out the baits like I'm going to be there at daylight, and I don't care, I'm going to be covered with water from the dew and everything like that, and that's okay, but I'm going to be there. I want to get that bait out there first. I want to get really good quality lures and scents on it. In fact, right up in the corner here, I will put a link to a video called How to Get Fast Action on Your Bear Baits. After you watch this video, watch that one. It'll definitely be worth it to you. So you want the bears first, and that you got great location, you got the good quality scents and lures, and you got the bait, and it's out there right away. Now point number three is you got to keep a low profile. You don't want to have other people knowing exactly where you're baiting. That means you're not driving a four-wheeler right up to your bait. That means you're not making a really distinct trail into your bait. You might come into your bait from about 3 different access points and 3 angles. Try to avoid situations where people can be driving along a logging road or maybe a four-wheeler trail and looking to go, somebody's been going back in there a lot. You don't want that. So you want to keep a pretty low profile. You want to bait at times when there aren't a lot of people in the wood. You know, avoid weekends and so forth. Try to bait when people won't see you coming and going. Try not to bait right after a rain where you're going to leave a lot of four-wheeler or truck tracks in the mud. So just kind of be cognizant of that. Try to keep a low profile and keep as much a secret as you can. And that's point three. Now point four is you got to pattern other hunters. You have to know where other people are baiting and just kind of have a feel for how many baits are around you and what times other people are baiting and so forth and how often they're baiting. You really want to pattern the other hunters by looking for tracks and once again, I mentioned the four-wheeler tracks and pickup tire tracks or whatever. So just kind of have an overall feel. I mean, don't let this mess with you that there's other people around. And don't let it influence too much what you're doing. You got a good program, stick to it. But you kind of want to have this overall feeling of knowing what's going on around you, because it'll help you with your decision-making process. Number five is use high-quality bait. And it's so important to realize that your average bear hunter isn't taking this nearly serious enough. He's putting out a bunch of stale bread, or maybe just a big pile of candy or something like that. Maybe he's got a few pastries that he collected, but he's trying to ration them and so forth. If you're using really good quality bait and keeping it there, boy, you have a huge advantage. And that means you're going to probably have to spend some money to get really good bait. Okay, you want a variety of bait. You want some sweets like your pastries and stuff like that. You want your really good high carb, high protein baits that mimic the natural foods like trail mix. Trail mix is really, really important. I can go through literally, I'll go through 4 55-gallon drums of trail mix a year pretty easy on a few baits, because the bears love it and they will consistently keep coming back for that type of bait. So if you got some fruit you can put in there, you know, keep a good variety in there, and don't be afraid to spend the money on good quality baits, and then also use good quality lures. Your average guy is like, he gets a little jar of vanilla or maybe some molasses or something like that, or maybe some anise scent that he got from somewhere. If you use really good quality lures, you know, get those baits going with Gold Rush, and then use a good spray each time you come to visit the bait. So good quality baits, good quality lures, spend the money to do it right. You know, you might only be drawing a tag every few years, so make sure you're doing everything right and sparing no expense. Now, number six, of course, is don't run out of bait. That was one of the worst things you can do, is run out of bait. So bait as often as you have to make sure that there's always bait there. If you watch any of these, I got dozens and dozens of bear hunting videos on this channel, and there's an overall theme in bear baiting for me, and that is that every time a bear comes to the bait, I want to reward him with something good to eat. No exceptions. So bait as often as you have to. If you're in a state that restricts how much bait you can put out, then you got to bait more often. If you're not, then you can load 300 pounds of bait out there and only check it every 5 days or something like that. Great. But make sure there's good quality bait and it's always there. You don't want that bear to come back and sniff around and go, well, shoot, it's all gone, I'm gonna go somewhere else, because there's somebody else a couple miles away and he's gonna find their bait, and now you've lost that bear. So the same goes true if you have a bad rain, or we've got a really heavy rain and your bait's all gross and slimy, and you know, get it shoveled out of there, get fresh bait in there. You gotta be diligent about making sure that every time that bear comes back, he's rewarded with something good to eat. And number seven, also really, really important, is just never spook a bear off your bait if you can help it. That means you're really, really careful about going to the baits at times when the bears aren't coming. Watch your trail cameras. Make sure if you got a morning bear that's consistently coming in, maybe up until about 9 o'clock in the morning, you know, you want to make sure he's well out of that area. Don't start baiting there till 10. Don't bait in the afternoon after work or whatever, because there's too big of a chance that you're going to go out there at 4 or 5 o'clock or whatever, and there's going to be a bear on the bait. Never spook a bear off the bait if you can help it, because he might not come back in the daylight, or he might not come back at all if he goes and finds another bait for someone else. So that's the seven really, really important rules that I have for baiting on highly competitive public land. I really hope this helps you. If you're not a subscriber to this channel and you're a bear hunter, you're nuts. I mean, this is the best bear hunting channel for information on YouTube, so you ought to be a subscriber. Leave a comment below if you want to add anything to this. If you disagree with any of it, feel free to disagree. I love the discussion that goes on in the comment section below. So hit subscribe, hit like, and we'll see you on the next video. Thanks for joining me.